I'm Tahir. I'm working as a senior IOS engineer here at DBG. Welcome to Tech Bytes. Tech Bytes is all about the recent technological updates in the world. So this month's Tech Bytes begins with WhatsApp Web. So WhatsApp has launched their new desktop version called WhatsApp Web. It's a web app rather than a native client. Right now, it seems to work well only with Google Chrome. And to log in to WhatsApp Web, user need to scan a QR code which will mirror the messages and conversations from the mobile device to the WhatsApp Web. WhatsApp Web is available for Android, BlackBerry and Windows Phone users. Right now, due to some platform limitations, iOS users are not supported. So next is Microsoft HoloLens.
So how many of you have started using WhatsApp Web? Is anyone?
Okay. So those who have not used WhatsApp, so could you please explain the process at which they could use it?
Okay, to use WhatsApp Web, user need to scan a QR code. There will be a QR code. On scanning the QR code, user will be logged into WhatsApp Web. Okay. And the phone should be connected. If the phone is offline, then the session will be cancelled.
So it is not like a separate WhatsApp registration or anything like that. We should have a phone account and then it is just synced with the web. So when the phone is connected, then only you will receive the messages through WhatsApp.
Yeah. Okay, moving on, Microsoft HoloLens. Microsoft in its Windows 10 event has introduced a new augmented reality headset called Microsoft HoloLens. It's a wireless headset and does not need to pair with a computer or a mobile device. It has its own CPU, GPU and holographic processing unit. So let's see more about HoloLens in this video.
To visualize our work.
So that's all about Microsoft HoloLens. How? What?
So it is just in reality we can see those things.
Yeah. It said that it will fuse the real world with digital world. So we can see digital objects in the real world.
How do you want to bring that object? How does that work?
I want to do something like mapping or things are done.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. There's a headset, and I think Windows will provide more info about that. They have just introduced it. Okay. So, moving on, Twitter has introduced two new features: group direct messaging and native video sharing. With group direct messaging, a user can send messages to a private group, and Twitter has added a new video camera and editing features to its Twitter app to support native video sharing. With native video sharing, it's just that users can upload their video content directly to Twitter. And this video should not exceed a limit of 30 seconds. And finally, Windows 10 event updates. So, in the Microsoft Windows 10 event, they have provided a lot of data about the next generation operating system, Windows 10, how it will work across mobile, tablet, desktop, and other platforms. The biggest surprise was the Microsoft HoloLens and the Microsoft holographic software that Microsoft developed to support the Microsoft HoloLens. It's an augmented reality extension of Windows 10. And Windows 10 will be a free upgrade for Windows 7, Windows 8.1, and Windows Mobile 8.1 users within a year of Windows 10. So Windows 10 Mobile debuts with cross-platform features and Skype integration and some free apps such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint, etc. Windows 10 Gaming is more social and interactive with the inclusion of Xbox. And Windows has also introduced a new web browser called Spartan. It's supposed to replace Internet Explorer.
So it will be a great relief for the front-end developers. Okay. Maybe.
Yeah, Spartan is supposed to be more faster, compatible, and useful. And it has some interesting modes like some reading modes and PDF readers.
It's a clone of Chrome, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Okay, so that's all about Spartan and Windows 10, and yeah, I conclude this Tech Byte session. So now I invite Mr. Bibu to have a quick recap session. Thank you.